Welcome to Positive Atheism English Channel. Today, from the book The Life and Times of Gora, written by Mark Lindley, I am going to present you the remaining part of the 8th chapter, Gora's Political Activism in the 1950s and 60s. I should mention, because it led to Gora's travels abroad, the Delhi-Peking International Friendship March, which the Gandhi Peace Foundation helped organize in reaction to the October 1962 border war between India and China. On the anniversary in January 1963 of Gandhi's assassination, 16 marches from 5 countries set out from the site of his cremation. The march ended a year later near the border, where they had waited hopefully for 3 months for Chinese visas, which they were never granted to them. One of them was Lavanam, and he thereby became friends with an energetic Quaker from Philadelphia, George Willow, who consequently arranged for him and Vijay and now each to study in the USA. Gora, meanwhile, tried to do something in Andhra Pradesh about pomplessness, even though partylessness was proving an elusive goal. This time, his public protest would focus not on the legislatures as in his 1960 march, but on the chief minister, the top elected official of the province, who was a friend and admirer of his, and this time he prepared thoroughly for the gesture that would court arrest. When in September 1963, he and a dozen supporters squatted day and night in front of the chief minister's formal residence, hundreds of supporters throughout the province held public meetings and sent telegrams of support, while the Hyderabad newspapers published articles and photographs. The chief minister, who was a well-seasoned politician, let the support for Gora's cause build up for 5 days and then issued a public statement asking the squatters to end their protest and offering, in that case, to meet with Gora, Vinoba and the chief ministers of the 3 neighboring provinces in order to draw up some constructive measures with a view to having them adopted nationally in due course. So, Gora terminated the protest, met with the chief minister and sent a letter to Vinoba, who however declined to help on the grounds that he had nothing special to contribute, they could carry on without him. This was a shock to everyone who had expected leadership from Vinoba. Later, the Andhra chief minister circulated a letter to the other 3 soliciting their ideas, and Gora wrote to the president of the Indian National Congress, but then the Andhra chief minister resigned his office in order to take a position in the national cabinet. The new chief minister was unsympathetic to the effort, and the Congress president took the opportunity to back out of it. Gora kept on trying with the new chief minister, letters, squatting, negotiations, etc. The outcome was a set of regulations issued in October ordering that, number 1, the provincial ministers shun lavish dinners during their official travels in Andhra Pradesh. Number 2, the Andhra Pradesh Department of Agriculture grow more fruit trees in government office compounds instead of merely decorative flowers, which Gora considered a form of stately pomp. The trees are still there. And number 3, 2/3 of the flowers in the gardens surrounding the chief minister's official residence be replaced with vegetables. Gora was not against flowers, but only against the subsidized cultivation in a society where many people were going hungry. In the spirit of this initiative, vegetables were planted on the strips of land surrounding government offices throughout Andhra, and several of the ministers undertook to receive only fruits rather than flower bouquets at public functions. To spread the idea that a nation with famines and malnutrition should make it a high priority to reduce them, Gora organized at Vijayawada in November 1965 a Grow More Vegetables rally sponsored jointly by ASM and the provincial government and attended by about 1,000 people. At this rally, some saplings of fruit trees were planted in a public park, and 2 provincial ministers promised to decline in future any flower garlands and to request instead of a piece of fruit or a garland of vegetables. For 2 or 3 years after that, all the state ministers in Andhra observed this custom, but then Hindu tradition that the vested interests of flower garland producers, whom one still find today in any Indian city making and vending their wares, gradually got the upper hand. It was in 1963 that Gora had invented the custom of bestowing vegetable garlands, pieces of carrot, cauliflower, etc. on a card instead of flowers at public meetings and on festive occasions. Then the garland would be handed over to a cook who would use it to make a curry. Gora spent much of 1965-66 in Kerala promoting his concept of partyless democracy. The situation there was again rather like it has been in 1959, and the Gandhians asked him to return and lead a campaign throughout the province. Part of the plan this time was to publish, starting in January 1966, an English language journal edited by Gora, entitled Partyless Democracy. A liberal-minded Christian in a predominantly Roman Catholic town, Kottayam, contracted to print it, but then reneged because he feared an economic boycott led by his priest. So only 4 issues, prepared on a poorly equipped press belonging to a local Hindu, appeared. In 1967, Gora was a candidate for the Vijayawada seat in the provincial legislature. As in 1952, his purpose was merely to promote some of his radical ideas about the political process. This time, he was able to get the Congress Party candidate to discuss some of the issues face-to-face with other candidates at a public meeting. In March 1968, he organized in Hyderabad a Voters Week propagating his political themes and the Gandhian concept of constructive work. As a modest example of constructive work for town dwellers, he suggested that in their private gardens, they replace the flowers with the vegetables. He said, "We can't leave everything to the government. We have to do something constructive ourselves." However, that week of consciousness rising was also in preparation for his next political protest. The provisions of the 1964 agreement, which he had negotiated with the chief minister, had been implemented enthusiastically for a while, but were now being ignored. So Gora notified that good man that a group of protesters would on a certain day in mid-March uproot some of the flowers in the public garden opposite the state legislature building and plant fruits and vegetables in their place. The chief minister had the 22 protesters arrested and jailed for destroying government property. They, of course, declined to post a bail as their whole purpose was to drum up publicity for their cause. The tactic worked. In the state legislature, the face-saving argument was advanced that since Gora was a botanist, his advice about plants should of course be followed. So the case was dropped, the prisoners were released, and after a month, during which the jailers had become their friends and had suggested to no avail that they simply walk out and let the government forget about them. Instead, they grew vegetables in the prison yard, and the agricultural department introduced vegetables and fruit trees in the public gardens. In most of the meetings organized by Gora ever since his first atheist conference in 1941, most of the people attending had very little or no formal education, and there had been very little intellectual discussion apart from Gora answering questions. The conferences on partyless democracy had been more intellectual, mainly because the Marxists were agricultural in their opposition to the idea, but still Gora himself was regarded less as an intellectual than an activist. So, in the fall of 1968, he jumped at the opportunity to collaborate with some other intellectuals in putting on conferences in 2 large towns, Bangalore and Tiruchi, in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, on the theme of partyless democracy. About 100 people attending, each of them city folk with Western type higher education, lawyers, professors, etc., they discussed elegant resolutions, a far cry from the simple slogans like "grow vegetables instead of flowers" and "let the ministers travel third class" that Gora had so often used. In January 1969, there was another upsurge of political violence in Telangana. This time, for the sake of making Telangana a separate province of India, Gora organized and led in February a peace march in the most severely affected district. He persuaded the agitators to give up their violence and go in for public debate and lobbying. The result of the whole episode was that Telangana did not become a separate province, but the chief minister of Andhra Pradesh resigned, and his replacement, a man from Telangana appointed by the Congress, saw to it that relatively more of the provincial government's expenditures were allocated to Telangana than before. This led in 1972 to hesitation in some other parts of Andhra Pradesh to shed Telangana from the province. That latter hesitation became severe, disrupting communications and travel for about 2 weeks, which happened to be just when Gora's first World Atheist Meet was held at Vijayawada. Thank you. We'll meet in the next episode again.
Please download Samaram Multichannel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store, and subscribe to the channels. For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.